Jashi Delu. And I would like to share some teaching which is related with my own experience. So nowadays, many people asking me, what is your experience? And please share us a little bit about your journey and a little bit about your meditation experience while going into the mountains. So I would like to share you a little bit about my first year experience. So I hope maybe it will help you, because it's really helped me. So my journey start with a great strong idea about retreat. So I want to live on street, and I don't want to fix any schedule, no fixed plan, and wander place to place, something like that. So I have some expectation, and very exciting first. So then I leave from Buddh Gaya Monastery. From there I went to Varanasi. And then I reached the Varanasi train station. So there's not very big train station, just I think relatively quite small. And then there's some kind of like feel outside also. And you can stay inside, you can sleep at the train station. You know, in India, we can do that. So I really want to do that. So I arrived there, and I tried to sleep on the street, you know. And I sit there and look. So there are so many people, and special people who don't have money to rent a room. They stay there. So I stay there. But that was very difficult. So I feel, so my mind say okay, but my feeling, my body say not okay. I feel embarrassed, shy. I feel like everybody's looking at me, you know. Even some police, they come looking at me, you know. So, but I still try to stay. After a few hours later, I cannot stay. Then I book the room upstairs. There's a dormitory I can stay in. I can book one bed. It's not expensive also. So I move up there. I feel, wow, very good. So then, next day, I still want to stay on the street. So I come down, try to stay. I stay longer than yesterday. Why? Because I have very strong, fixation, strong grasping of, I cannot let go. I cannot really let go of my attachment about my body, my food, my comfortable room, and comfortable surroundings, because I've been grew up in good family, and I have name that like Rinpoche. So I get good food every day. I have very nice bed, and people treating me very well, treating me as like princess. So I have all those things, and suddenly I try to stay on road. It's very difficult. And it's very difficult to let go of all this attachment. So the next day, I stayed longer, but then in the end, I again booked the room. So I stayed there about two days. Then after that, I moved to Kushinagar. And I want to stay on the street again, but cannot stay on the street. So I stay in the room, very cheap. So meanwhile, I try to train myself to let go of all my habit, and try to be one with environment, a different environment. So I stayed there for a few weeks, and slowly, my money is running out. I don't have much money. I didn't brought a lot of money. So money is also running out. So I thought, so this is a good opportunity because I cannot stay in the hotel room, because my money is finished. So then I stay on the street. The first night was very difficult. So at the night, even dogs also chasing me. If I stand up and go for toilet, all the dogs chase after me, oh, like that. So, but I managed that night. So then, I don't have money, and I don't have much things to eat. So before, when I have money, there's one restaurant. So I order food from there before. So I went there, asked them, now all my money is finished. So if you have any left over, could you please give me? They said, okay, but you can come at late evening, at the night. So they will give me left over. So I go there, and they give me left over. Then somehow, maybe water or something, I got sick. So diarrhea, also vomiting, diarrhea. And then after 2 days later, I feel like I'm going to die. So one morning, I couldn't get up. My body is so weak. And slowly, so I cannot move my body. And then I thought I'm going to die. So I make a decision that, okay, I think I'm going to die. Let it be. Let it die. So I try to sit straight, sit up, and then we have like dying meditation. Meditation of dying, and also Bardo meditation. Bardo meaning is after death, the intermediate state practice. So I did all this practice, and slowly, I see the dissolution of my senses. So I cannot see, I cannot hear. I don't know if my body is paralyzed or not, but my mind is so clear. And I see some colors, then I feel like I'm falling down. And then gradually. Then in the end, my mind became even more clear. So vivid, there's no concept. No, there's no normal thought, no monkey mind. Everything dissolved. But at the same time, it's like blue sky with sun shining. So brilliant, pervasive, and so happy, joyful. So I rest with that state. I don't know how long. Then suddenly I feel like, okay, now this is not the time for me to die now. So that kind of thought comes and becomes stronger. Then suddenly I feel like my body. Before this, like my mind is totally open and pervasive, and suddenly become like narrow and feel the body. So then slowly, I can open my eyes. I can hear the sound, something like that. Then I can move, and I stand up and try to look for water, and I faint. Then I end up in the hospital. Someone took me to hospital. I will end up in hospital. There's glucose, some kind of like water, putting in my nerve. Yeah. So then after that, I feel so happy. And then my, this old habit, the layers of attachment, grasping, all these things are gone. And everything what I see, what I hear, even I walk, it's very nice, pleasant. And I have very deep feeling of gratitude or appreciate about everything. Even breath, I feel appreciate of just having breath. I'm appreciate of just can see the trees. And it's the same tree, but it's like more fresh, more green, and it's like, how to say? It's, the tree is made of joy, made of like love of joy, something like that. Yeah. So then I can stay on the road, no problem. I can be with the beggars, and I can stay in the hotel, I can stay on the road, I can stay in the mountain, and I can travel. And after that, my health is also good. So after that, my journey was fantastic, and my health is good, and everything's okay. So now I want to tell you that this is a very profound experience for me, but maybe you might think, in order to get that kind of profound experience, do I need to have this near-death experience, or do I need to go to street in India, street just like me? My answer is not necessary. I think you can find similar situation in your life. For example, heartbreak, very common, right? So we all have some kind of like expectation about what our future should be. We are, how to say, almost subconsciously planning about our future. This is the way, this should be, I need that, I'm like that, you know. So we try to control the future. And this is not just in our intellectual mind, there's the subconscious mind, there's our belief, everything very solid. So once you check that, then people fall into big depression, or a lot of things happen. So, but I think my idea is that is the one of the best opportunity to practice. If you use this opportunity as support for your meditation or deal with your meditation, I think that's the best opportunity. So you will get similar experience as what I did, I think. And also lost job or losing loved one or sick, physical sick sometime. So there are many opportunities. So if you face in your life something very difficult situation, which is beyond your expectation, beyond your belief, beyond your normal expectation, then that's the best opportunity to practice meditation. So when you have this situation, you try to use meditation with that situation to see this attachment and go beyond that. And then after that, then you will feel a lot of rejoice, gratitude. So maybe I want to give you simple practical homework about the about appreciation. So another thing is this appreciation practice, you don't have to wait until heart broke. Like heart broke or losing job, is good to cut your grasping. But there's another practice, which is you can develop appreciation every day, little bit. So maybe you can appreciate about your being life, appreciate about your breath. Wonderful, I have breath, how nice. Or if you see something, just appreciate that you can able to see. You have nice, wonderful eyes, which is you can see the trees, mountains, houses, people. So appreciate that you can able to see. You can appreciate that you can able to hear. You can appreciate that you have food that you can eat. So there's basic things which is already exist within you. Normally we are not appreciating. We're taking for granted. So now begin to see those things. So you can come out every day at least 3 appreciation. So some people, they think, okay, I don't have much things to appreciate. I don't have any goodness within me. But actually you have. You can think that I don't have goodness. It's wonderful, right? You can able to think, I don't have goodness. So able to think is nice. So you can appreciate, I can think of that. That's already have. You already have one. So do it, this small practice. And try to come out every day something new, or you can change different object day to day. Okay. Thank you.